Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, we're going to show you how to turn on advanced data protection for iCloud. So let's begin. Before we begin, we have to make sure that all of our devices are on the latest software. So if you're on an iPhone, make sure you have iOS 16.2. If you're on an iPad, make sure you have iPadOS 16.2. If you have a Mac, make sure I'm macOS 13.1. If you're on an Apple Watch, make sure to have watchOS 9.2. If you're on Apple TV, make sure to have tvOS 16.2. And if you have any HomePods, make sure they're on version 16.0 or later. And if you have a Windows computer using iCloud, make sure you're on version 14.1 or later. And the reason we want all these devices to be up to date isn't just because of the feature being supported on these versions, is because if one of these devices aren't on the latest version, there could be problems where your device may not be able to access iCloud or things like that because of this feature. And we'll get into that a little bit later on. Now, let's begin. The first thing we're gonna do is open settings. Once we have settings open, we're gonna tap on our name. Then we're gonna tap on iCloud. Once that's done, you're gonna scroll down to advanced data protection. And down below, we can enable it right from there. Now, let's get into what this feature actually does and why you might want to turn it on. Advanced data protection is designed to give you full end-to-end encryption for your iCloud data. So currently, according to Apple, 14 sensitive data categories already use end-to-end decryption by default. With this feature being turned on, that number rises to 23. And so end-to-end encryption means that you're the only one with the key, basically, to your data. No one else, not Apple, not any organization, can access your data. That's yours, and that's it. It's good from a privacy standpoint, but if you ever forget your key to your data, like your password, and don't have a backup method enabled, you won't be able to regain access to your account, and Apple won't be able to help you. But if this feature is not on, Apple can help you regain access to your account because they will have the key. So there's kind of some pros and cons to this feature being enabled. But the good thing is Apple does have backup methods you can use to protect your data. And this method could be a recovery contact. If you enable a recovery contact, this will be during the setup process, it will ask you for this. You can have a contact that you trust to give you the key to regain access to your account. So if you forget, you do have a backup method. But if you don't have anybody to do this with that you trust enough, probably don't turn this on so that you can still regain access into your account. Anyways though, thanks for watching.